at least 95% of the human energy is simply wasted because most human beings cannot hold anything in their focus. Otherwise, each of them would be opening up a new window, a new door to something else.
Are you hearing what I'm telling you? You're not hearing what I'm telling you? Y'all thinking it's about talent, it's not. It's about taking the gift you got and laying hold of it. Have you ever laid hold of something? I fought too long. I fought too hard. If I was going to quit Satan, you should have got me a 17-year-old. You should have broke me when I was eating out of trash can. It's too late now. I'm in the Ritz-Carlton. It's too late now. I'm telling you, greatness is here, but it ain't on Cam's shoulders no more. It ain't on Farley's shoulder no more. It ain't on Bo Jackson's shoulder no more. Now greatness is on whose shoulder? That's why I wake up every morning at 2 o'clock, 2:30. Because I got my mama counting on me. I got my sister counting on me. I got my son and my daughter counting on me. I got a world that gets up every morning and watches me. I got little kids who don't believe that they can do it. When they saw me, they thought now they can do it. So I get up every morning at 2:30, 3 o'clock. Why? Because greatness is upon me. Dr. King is dead. Malcolm X is dead. I'm that new guy. I'm that new inspiration. I'm the guy you look at when your daddy ain't in your life, when your daddy in prison. I'm that guy that comes to your high school and tell you, you can make it happen. Greatness is upon you, you better act like it. What's your passion? What's your drive? What's your purpose? What's your purpose for playing this game? Why are you doing what you're doing? And when you know why you're doing what you're doing, you saw my t-shirt, no alarm clock needed. My passion wakes me up. I got up at 3 o'clock this morning, no clock. I ain't used a clock in 20 years. My passion wakes me up. My drive wakes me up. My determination wakes me up. My ability to be, do, and have whatever I want, it wakes me up. What wakes you up? What drives you? Why are you playing this game? Is it just a game? Or do you eat it? Do you sleep it? Do you drink it? Have you possessed the game? Do you want to change the game? I'm sitting with a D1 basketball player this morning, freshman. He pulled out a piece of paper and he showed me 20 goals, what he wants to accomplish in Big Ten. 18-year-old kid, 20 goals. I asked him, why you got these goals? He said, because right now, my mama ain't eating.
And I'm better than you with this and I'm better than you with that. And I finally found something that, yeah, this kid over here, you know, he may have more chicks. Like he may have better clothes or whatever, but he can't do this like me. You know what I mean? He can't write what I'm writing right now. And it started to feel like, you know, maybe Marshall's getting a little respect.
So when you're not where you want to be financially, it means that you may be adding value, but not significant enough value. But I dare you to fail in writing for a whole year to see if you can get to the end. I dare you to fail. I dare you to take that same class over and over again. I dare you to stop dropping classes like you saw. Some of you need to give up your cell phone because the time you spend on your cell phone could be used for your success. The time you could be using to be successful, you're using it on the cell. And the cell phone is not bringing you nothing but a bill.
One of the secrets of success is for you or me to find out what we're good at and have a passion to do it and stay in our strength.